Welcome to this week's edition of Grilling Stafford with Navasota City Manager Brad Stafford, along with the Navasota Examiner and Willie 98.7 FM.
Good morning, Navasota. How is everybody today? How's Anna and Kenny?
We're good, Brad. How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
Got Anna Casino and Kenny Graves. We're glad to have them. Real country. Princess of Print with us today. Always glad to be back for Grilling Stafford. Hope everybody's had a great week, and here y'all have some questions for me.
We do.
Well, let's go.
Let's do it, Brad. All right, Brad, how many COVID-19 cases are in the city?
Hot off the press, today we have 70 active cases in the city.
All right.
All right, Brad.
You got to remember, I think I say this every week or at least every other week, you know, increased testing is always cause and effect. You know, if
right.
you have more tests, you're always going to have more more positive cases. You know, don't really want people to be sick, but I always want to make sure that people understand with more tests, you will have more cases.
Okay, Brad. Operation Blue Santa is back this year. How can businesses or individuals get involved and help out?
Yeah, isn't that a great event?
Is.
Blue
it
Santa
really
is a good deal. Well, they can sure participate by sponsoring. And to do that, they just need to call Lieutenant Mize at the Navasota Police Department. He'll be glad to help them out and get them pointed in the right direction so that they can participate in this year's Blue Santa Drive. It's a great event for a lot of our needy folks, needy kids in our community.
I absolutely agree. Brad, there was a record turnout in Grimes County for the 2020 election. Do you have any numbers for the city of Navasota?
I want to say, and I'm sorry, I didn't bring that with me today, but I think that we had around 1,200 or 1,300 voters in the city, which, you know, was great. You know, I can remember years where we had 200.
Yeah.
So it was really nice to see that we had a good turnout.
We really did.
Yeah, I mean, I know it was a great turnout across the country this year, and, you know, I think there was a little thing called the presidential election that, mm-hmm. that caused all of that to happen.
Yeah.
But,
Okay, Brad, can you tell us about Home for the Holidays? That's coming up on Saturday, December 12th.
You bet. That's another great event.
It really is.
Of course, it's being modified this year, you know, and I know that there are folks that are concerned. We do still have the lighted Christmas parade. We are going to have some live music. Little change up from last year or previous years. Most everything will be on Washington Avenue or right off of Washington Avenue. We won't have the bounce houses or the skating rink this year. Just trying to take the necessary precautions to keep people from unnecessary exposure. But all the stores are going to have specials. There'll be cookies and hot chocolate and who knows what other kind of surprise may come up between now and the 12th. Our staff, the chamber, you guys have all put a lot of effort into this to try and really create a memorable event for folks. Even, you know, 2020 memorable events are different than all other years.
Yeah, for sure.
But it's going to be fun. It's going to be a great time for people to come out and enjoy a country Christmas.
Well, I'll tell you what, you had me at cookies and hot chocolate.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, I saw you. I could tell you were ready for that. Wait till you see some of this.
The parade.
Madison's worked pretty hard on that.
The Christmas parade is one of the best we have. Sure.
One of the best in the country.
It's a really good parade.
Yeah, I get lots of compliments every year that it's one of the better parades that anybody attends.
Oh, it's a really
And of course,
good.
That's thanks to all of our participants mm-hmm. who just do a great
job. They
do
an amazing job with their
You know, I'm every year I'm amazed at the way that and the thought that goes into these floats that people are putting together. It's just unbelievable.
They really are. Yeah. All right, Brad, in a recent issue of The Examiner, Energy posted a notice to implement revised fixed fuel factor, a tariff. What will it affect what the city pays? Will this affect the recently passed 2021 budget?
Yes, it will affect us. I mean, it's not like it's a large sum of money, but it will affect us. And every year, multiple times throughout the year. If you really watch all of those ads, I'm sure you watch them since you print them.
I do.
They come out because they have the ability to recover costs. I mean, that's how they stay in business, and they've got to recover their costs as well. You know, I do want people to know that we do watch those things, and when we have the ability to participate or interject into those rate cases, we do. The city of Navasota is a member of a coalition of cities served by Entergy, and have an attorney that helps us out to just to make sure. You know, they run the numbers themselves for us as well, and get experts to run the numbers just to make sure. Not that Entergy's trying to do anything under the table, because they're not. They're just we just want to make sure. You know, people check out every bill they get, so you want to make sure that we're doing our part to help our citizens. It could cost us more money, but it won't be this big budget buster for us.
Okay. All right, Brad, here's just an easy question. Do we have anything new coming in 2021?
Yeah, you always say they're easy.
Is that easy?
It's always easy when you're asking.
Yeah. Is that really an easy question?
It is an easy question. I had to think a minute, but that's why I'm delaying harassing you, so it gives me time to think.
All the time you need.
One of the big things, of course, this has been happening for several years now, is new rooftops coming to town. Our residential development continues to boom. We continue to meet regularly with developers who want to be in Navasota. Citizens or folks, people who want to come be citizens of Navasota. So, of course, that's the big new thing, and we've talked about it all the time, the great things that are happening in our commercial side, new restaurant downtown, new hotel downtown, new retail space and apartments downtown. Just a lot of cool things that keep us going. And you know, the biggest thing that I would hope that's new in 2021 is we don't have so much COVID running around. But yeah, that's a lot of what's happening and what we've got to look forward to. And, you know, we're just a couple of months away from 2021. So.
That's it.
I heard somebody say they were going to have a big blowout for their New Year's party because they were ready to get rid of 2020.
Couldn't argue that point.
Some things have been really good for the city in 2020, but yeah. Some things have been tough.
Yeah.
That's quite a bit of what we've got going on. So next, we're going to meet the staff. We've been doing that now for a couple of months, and hopefully you've got some really good insight on who works here. And this one that you're going to meet today is Jeff Greer. Jeff's the utility director for the city. He's one of those stories, kind of like some of the past guys that we've talked, or folks we've talked about, that have worked their way up through the ranks. I think Jeff's worked for us on two or three different occasions, a total of around 24 years. He's been a dog catcher. He's done, I don't know what all he's done, gas superintendent. He's done a lot of things, and as you're going to find out when you listen to Jeff, he's got a lot of experience both here and in the world. And he's been a great asset to the city. Take it away, Jeff.
Hello, name is Jeff Greer. I'm the Director of Utilities for the City of Navasota. And I have actually worked for the city three different times, on three different occasions. I first started in the early 90s. I was part-time parks and part-time animal control officer. So I did that for about a year and a half, and then there was an opening in the utility department. So that's what I really wanted to do. So I moved over as soon as I could and started out as a laborer and worked my way through, got my licenses, water license, wastewater license, moved into the gas department, and moved my way up to foreman in the gas department. And then I was here for about 10 years at that time, and I went to work. I had an opportunity to go to work overseas, so I did that with Brown & Root for about 5 years. Then I came back at around 2006, and I worked for the city another couple of years and went out to the prison, worked out there for a while, and ran their water plant for them, their water and wastewater. And that's when the utility superintendent job opened up again for the city. And it was another opportunity for me to continue working for the city after a couple of breaks. And so I came back and worked my way up from utility superintendent and into director of public works. So all in all, I've got 24 years in with the city. 24 exactly. I checked it just earlier. So I really like working here. I like it's a challenge. Lots of challenges. You never know what you're going to run into from one day to the next. And the people that I work with are really good people. You know, they try really hard. Meeting new people, you know, our customers, there's always something different going on here at the city. So that's really what I like the most about my job. So all in all, it's good to meet you guys.
All right. Thanks, Jeff. That's awesome. What a great guy.
He really is.
Yep, he's a good guy. We're always proud to hear about these folks that are success stories, that are moving up and doing things, and just great to hear about them.
For sure. All right, Brad. In the vicinity of the water tower, there was a very large crane. Is a new communications tower going up, or is it an existing one being worked on? To whom does the tower belong, and what's on it?
It is not a new tower. It is a construction project to improve or change some of the equipment that's on an existing cell phone tower, I believe. I don't really remember who the owner is, but it's a cell phone tower.
Okay.
You know, there's a pretty big process anymore for these people to put a new tower in. So if a new tower was going in, there would be some public hearings and all
right.
kinds of fun things.
Yep.
Y'all may remember we had that just a few years ago. Got pretty drawn out over time.
Yep.
So.
Okay. Brad, on the corner of Holland and Church Streets, there is a Save a Child sign or something similar that is bolted to one of the stop signs. Does the city do that? Who decides what message goes on the sign? And what is the procedure for requesting a similar sign at another location?
Well, that sign has been in that location since before I came here, because I saw it when I moved to town. I don't know who put the sign there. It's not normal city sign. It's not a sign that it actually has a design on it that I want to say maybe one of the churches put that up. That's today. That probably would, you know, be a little more difficult just because you've got regulations on placing signs, and maybe I don't know if somebody asked or didn't ask. I don't know what happened. Requesting signs goes through a process. It has to be approved, you know, through staff and city council. The messages normally are just traffic related, you know, stop signs, yield signs, speed limit signs. Those type signs are what we put up. I mean, there are other signs, but normally those are the main ones. And a request would just have to go through staff and then eventually get to a city council meeting.
Okay.
This question was submitted to us last minute, Brad. The alley between Farquhar and Railroad Street, is that a public roadway or a parking lot? Every time I attempt to drive through it, because Railroad Street is closed, it is blocked by trucks, trailers, and construction vehicles.
It's actually a public right-of-way, not a roadway. It is blocked quite a bit right now due to the numerous construction projects that are occurring over there. Actually, traffic that is avoiding the closed Railroad Street should be utilizing Farquhar Street or 10th Street. Not really the alleyway.
Mm-hmm.
The alleyway is more for service to get utility vehicles in and out, and of course the service trucks and vehicles for maintenance on the facilities that are adjacent to those buildings, not so much for people to drive through. It is blocked and it is difficult sometimes to get through there, and it's just due to the construction, and there's really no place for those construction vehicles to be right now due to all the construction on the front side on Railroad Street. So it's just kind of one of those things where we all have to work together and may have to change our routines just a little bit. But really, vehicular traffic should take 10th Street or Farquhar Street to avoid Railroad.
Okay.
And
that's all we have besides the fun question.
I'm always hungry when I'm leaving here, so therefore a lot of my questions are revolved around food. But I discussed this on the air with Miranda last week because Thanksgiving is next week. Hypothetically, Brad, if there was a shortage and you couldn't get your hands on turkey or ham, what would you replace it with at your house?
Well, there's no shortage of anything else?
No, I'm just hypothetically.
Just turkey or ham.
Yeah, but you had to get something different besides those. What would you go with?
Steak.
Protection.
Same.
I might prefer steak anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
I've always been of the mindset that I would like a tradition of Thanksgiving enchiladas.
That's a tradition at our house for Christmas, at my mom's house. My mom's house, it's enchiladas. My house, with my wife, it's Italian food.
I know where to come then. Yeah. Christmas, right?
That's right.
Set a place.
Very good.
What about you? What'd you say?
Same.
Steak?
Yeah.
Right.
I prefer the sides anyway, but...
What do you like? Send us a message on Facebook. We want to know what you would eat if you didn't have turkey or ham.
Right.
All right. Well, that's it.
That's it, Brad.
All right. Well, thanks, guys. Appreciate it. As always, we appreciate Kenny and Anna and everybody else, all of the city staff for helping out, everybody over at the Examiner and at Willie for helping us out, and we appreciate you watching. If you have questions, let these two know so they can grill Stafford. Look forward to seeing you next week. Everybody have a great rest of your week and a great weekend.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.